Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel Yavil's Tutorial. Hope you are all doing well. So in today's session, I'm coming up with a new concept that is emerging technologies in internet and networking, which is the fifth module for MCOM students, KUD. So without wasting much of the time, let's start. In this video, we will be discussing introduction to internet and its history and also the fundamentals of internet. Basically, let us try to understand what do you mean by internet. The internet is a global system of which is having the interconnection of a computer network, which uses the internet protocol to link billions of devices throughout the world. So, in simple terms, what we can say, internet is nothing but the network of computer networks, we can say. In this slide, we are focusing on the history of internet. Mainly, in 1969, it is the year of internet, we can say, because ARPANET, which is also called as Advanced Research Project Agencies Network, which was commissioned by Department of Defense, it was doing a research into networking, and it was a great success in 1969. In 1971, people started communicating with each other by using email kind of facilities. And in 1973, global networking became into reality, so that people of one network are able to communicate or able to interact with other networks. So that is simply we can say inter-networking got succeed in 1973. In 1991, a friendly user interface to www established. So www is nothing but a World Wide Web, which was released by CRN, and Tim Berners-Lee was the developer of this www. And in 1999, people started using wireless technologies like Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, infrared, and satellite-based communication. And this is nothing but how internet has been developed from 1969 to today. Now, let us try to understand what are the fundamentals of internet. So, there are web browsers, servers, search engines, emails, social media, the communications and computer networking basics, and even the security issues which are related to internet. So these are the essential fundamentals which are required to establish an internet. Let us see one by one. Now let's try to understand what do you mean by web client and server. Client or servers, these are nothing but machines. How we are going to bifurcate whether this machine is a client and this machine is a server based on the application that we are going to execute in the machine. Normally, in a client, what we are going to use? We are going to use a client-side applications. For example, we may use web browsers to send the request to the server. In servers, what happens? We are using a server-side applications by using a certain programming languages. The main task of a client is it has to always send a request to the server. The server, it has to accept the request which is coming from the client, and it has to process it, and it has to generate the proper response. So this is what how actually the interaction happens between web browsers to web server. Next fundamental of internet is web search engine, which is the system software which is specifically designed to search for particular information on World Wide Web. Normally, there are several web search engines available in the market. Most familiar one is Google, or else you can make use of MSN, AskMe.com, Yahoo servers. So these are what several examples of web search engines. By using these web search engines, we can search for a particular information on the internet. Normally, we can go for website search, or we may go for image search also, we may go for video search, etc. The next one is email, which is also called as electronic mail. Electronic mail was implemented in the year 1971. There are so many email service providers available in the market. For example, Yahoo Mail, Rediff Mail, Gmail, and so on. Through this email, people can send messages with each other by using electronic media. Normally what happens, sender, he makes use of a sender's email service provider and he is going to compose a mail and it will be forwarded through the destination address obtained from DNS server. What do you mean by DNS? It is nothing but a domain name system server. And it forwards that message to recipient's email service provider and recipient are able to get the message which has been sent by the sender. This is how electronic mail functions. The next fundamental of internet is social media. These are the computer mediated technologies which provides the facility for the users to create, share information or ideas or other forms of expressions by using virtual communities and networks. Most commonly used social medias are YouTube, Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn, etc. The next one is internet communication. These are the services through which user can interact with each other. Most commonly used internet communication services are nothing but VoIP, Voice over Internet Protocol, through which user can send his voice commands over the IP, Internet Protocol. The next one is user can communicate with each other by using a certain web conferencing services or audio conferencing services. He can share even his screen also. He can make use of certain messaging apps to communicate with each other, or else he can make use of a file transfer protocol to share the files between the computers. And also he may control other computers by using a remote desktop kind of tools. These are what internet communication fundamentals. One is a networking fundamental, that is nothing but a computer network. What do you mean by computer network? It is a digital telecommunications network for sharing certain resources between nodes, which uses a common telecommunications technology. These nodes are nothing but any machine or system which is nothing but acting like a communication endpoint. These nodes are identified by IP addresses, that is nothing but internet protocol address, which is unique throughout the globe. Networking fundamental makes use of certain network devices to establish a successful connection among the devices. Normally we use hubs, switches, routers, modems and certain communication channels to establish a successful communication between the nodes. So what is the functionality of a hub? So you can look into the figure. So there are certain nodes connected to the hub. So hub is intelligent enough to identify what are the systems or hosts connected to it, but it fails to deliver the message to the desired destination. So normally hub will not identify the machine address. So here you can see here one person is sending the message, but the same message is going to deliver to the all nodes which are connected to the hub. But if we compare this hub with a switch, switch is intelligent enough, it is having the capacity to identify what are the hosts or systems nodes connected within the network, and also it is having the capacity to identify the address of each and every node. So in switch, what happens if one person is going to send the message to the desired destination? This switch will transfer that message to the respective destination successfully. So this is the difference between hub and switch. Hub will not identify the destination address. Irrespective of the destination address, it will distribute the message to everyone which are connected to the hub. But a switch, what happens? Switch will deliver the message to the destination IP address. If we compare the router, router will be helpful in identifying the routes. It will be helpful in identifying the shortest route to deliver the packets. Packets will have certain IP addresses. It is having the source IP address and it is also having the destination IP address. Router does the job of a traffic police. It delivers the packets or it shows the correct path for the packets to deliver the message to the right destination. Similarly, we use a modem device. Modem does the job of modulation and demodulation of the signals. Our computer is not having the capacity to deal with the analog signals. So, computer is nothing but a digital machine which is having the capacity to interact with the digital signals. So, here we require one device to modulate and demodulate the signals. So, modulation and demodulation task will be done by the modem device. So, along with this, we use a certain physical communication medias also, like a twisted pair wire, optical fiber cable, and even the coaxial cable. Along with the networking devices, networking fundamentals makes use of IP suite, which is a conceptual model and set of communication protocol used in the network to provide end-to-end communication between the systems or nodes. Most commonly used models are OSI reference model and TCP/IP model. Regarding these models, I have already uploaded videos. If you have not gone through those videos, you can go through the videos to understand how communication happens between the systems, how data will be transferred from one system to another system. The videos and links I am going to provide in the description section. You kindly go through it if you have not gone through those videos to understand it in a better way. The last fundamental of internet is its security. The main objective of internet security is to establish rules and measures to use against attacks over the internet. The internet represents insecure channel for exchanging information, which leads to certain frauds like phishing, viruses, worms, trojans, etc. To avoid these kind of fraudulence, what we can implement? We can make use of cryptography technology. And we can make use of encryption, decryption techniques to transfer our confidential data over the internet. Encryption, what it does, it is going to convert the plain text into ciphertext. Plain text will be in the readable format and ciphertext will be in unreadable format. So, this ciphertext will be transferred over the communication channel over the internet. And at the destination side, it makes use of a decryption, which is going to convert the ciphertext into the plain text. So, in between, suppose if a third party, if he hacks our data, he will be not able to read the ciphertext content. So, this is what cryptography technology. And also, we can make use of a certain antiviruses. We can install antiviruses to avoid virus attacks to the computers. Or else, to protect our data, we can make use of authentication process so that system will identify the authorized person to access the confidential data. So, these are the security measurements we can consider during the internet security. Okay, with all these stuff, I'm going to conclude this video. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, kindly like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you once again.